Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on single phase and three phase inductive load. In this video we'll check the inductive load with the single phase and three phase supply, both the type of load condition we will observe in this. We'll check the ampere ratings of this, how much with this load can be withstand with the different type of loading condition. This load can be used with the balanced and unbalanced both type of conditions according to your requirement. We'll also explain you all the features of this complete load and we'll discuss about the basic applications, how much and how can you use this load at your different type of testing, calibration and other things also. So this is the closer look of the single phase and three phase inductive load. The order code is 46611. You can use this order code to find out all the specification about this inductive load, how you can use it or what are your applications, but by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. I will explain you some technical specification about the single phase and three phase inductive load. We have first MCB of 16 ampere, which is a 4-pole MCB, so you can connect a 3-phase input up to inside which it is already connected in star and delta, both the combination with this star delta selector switch provided. The off condition, the load will be remains in off condition. The star point will be connect the all coils of the 3 phases in the start position so that you can provide any star load, and the delta combination will be completely connected all 3 phases in the delta combination, so you can select the any of requirement load conditions for the suitable variations. Jewel lights of all the 3 phases is also provided, so you can check easily all the phases are working or not, or present or not. Then we have a 5-step MCB. Each MCB consists of 10 amperes of rating. This is a single pole MCB or provides 5-stepping of load condition in each phases, and when you are using the single phase you can use it with the complete 15 steps in the single phase condition. All the MCB can be withdraw up to 10 amperes of current for the delta conditions, and in the star condition the current rating will be 5 ampere per phase when you connecting all the 3 phase in 3-phase sequence. And when you are working with the single phase mode, you just need to turn this knob to the star connection. In the star connection, if you can use the single phase or the R phase of both the requirement load, you can use up to 5 ampere and you can extend the single phase operation with all the 3 loads provided up to 15 ampere. With the all 15 ampere connections, you can use this in series combination. We will explain it later in the video also. For the delta operations, just turn this switch to the delta condition and you can take up to 15 ampere load at each phase, all the 3 phases with this variable MCBs, so that you can unbalance or balance load whatever the power source is provided. You can connect the load in both the conditions easily. All the 3 terminals are provided for connecting the phase separately, R, Y, B. Also in the single phase condition you can connect it on the R and the neutral, or you can connect them in the series combination also, so that you can extend the current capacity or load capacity in the single phase. For the 3-phase combination, all the current capacity will be limited up to the 5 steps. The complete design of this load is made of the metal frame with the mesh provided on all the sides, so that easily cooling will be provided for all the loads inside it. The heavy duty wheels are also provided, so the load can be easily movable in your place, so that you can easily use this load, and the load is movable easily, just need to be pushed. The complete weight of this load around is about 70 kilograms approximately. Providing a user manual with this complete setup, so that all the safety instruction are mentioned, so you need to provide all the safety instructions. And for connecting the load, for the helping hand we have provided some procedure inside it for connecting it and for checking it, and this is all about this. Now we going to the testing mode. We will provide a three phase supply to terminals and a single phase supply to these terminals for checking the load in single and three phase condition. So for testing in single phase mode, I have connected a single phase supply with the R phase and a neutral point. This is the single phase board. On the right hand side you can see we have connected two wires on the red and black terminal. The neutral point is common for all the three phases. And now we will provide the three phase supply. We will turn on the main MCB after it, and before it we will turn this switch to the star position, the selector switch, and after that we will increase the load in steps and observe the output in the clamp meter for the current. So now first of all we will turn the selector switch to star position, and now we will turn on the power supply, and after that we will check the load condition. Now we will turn on the power from the power source, and now we will turn on the MCB of the main input. Here you can see there is only one jewel light is turning on because we have provided only single phase on the R phase. Now we will use this clamp meter for measure the current in phase, and we will continuously on the MCB one by one steps for loading the current to this inductive load. So I am turning this to ampere measurement. Here this is the 60 amperes range, and I am connecting this with the R phase. Right now you can see there is no ampere rating because the load is not on. We will one by one on the all MCB and check the load is increasing in this clamp meter. So on the first step, as I increase it, you can see the AC current is measured in this clamp meter, which is 1 ampere for this on the first step. Similarly, we will increase it to the second one. The ampere rating is increased to 2 amperes. Similarly, we will increase it to the third step. The ampere rating is 3.32 amperes in the clamp meter. And on the fourth step, the ampere rating increased 4.43 amperes in AC, and at the fifth step, the ampere rating is 5.56. So this is the approximately load conditions. Some of the variations is acceptable due to the load and the voltage are not constant at everywhere. So here you can see at the single phase on the first step, when we using only the single phase and single neutral, we can load up to 5.56 amperes for the single phase condition. Now after testing it, just turn off all the MCB, turn off the main MCB, also the power source. Now for extending it to the 15 steps, or you can use it to the 10 step as well. Just need to connect all the three phases in series. Now for extending the load steps, we just need to connect a patch cord using the terminals. We'll connect R with yellow phase and yellow phase with the blue one. So here on you can now connect the load up to 15 amperes in the increment. All the 15 steps can be used. We'll check it with the digital clamp meter also. So as we have turned on the power, now we'll turn on the mains input MCB so that load will be connected to the power source. And over here you can see right now all the three lamps of R by V phase indications are now glowing because we have provided series supplies at all the three phases. Now we'll use this clamp meter again, and here on we can increase the current up to 15 steps, up to 15 ampere for this. So we'll increase the steps quickly. This is the first step, 1 ampere. Second step, 2.23 amperes, 3.35, 4.46, 5.58. Now, in continuation, we can increase the steps from the lower rows also. This is 6.63 amperes, 7.78, 8.96, 9.99, or up to 10 amperes. This is now 11 amperes, 12.36, 13.51, 14.6, 15.72, and last one 16.87. So this is the maximum current rating will be loaded for this inductive load. So that's how you can increase the load up to your requirement from 1 amperes to 16.87 amperes depending on your load demand. So we'll turn off the main MCB. All the loads will be cut. Make sure always you turn off all the MCB, otherwise complete load will be excess current for the higher ampere ratings, and that can be damage some source also inside the inductors of this inductive load. Moving on to the next, now we have connected all the three phases to all the three terminals. You can see over here the red, yellow and blue, all the three phases are now connected at all the respective terminals. Now we'll turn it in the star mode first and check the load conditions per phase by measuring it with the digital clamp meter. So first of all, we'll turn on the main input source that I have turned on, and now we turn this selector switch first to the star condition. After using the load, make sure you always turn this selector switch to the off condition. Now we'll turn on the main MCB. Over here you can see all the three phases are indicated, that all the three phases are present to this load. Now we'll one by one increase the load condition in all the three MCBs and check the load output. So as I have turned on the first MCB in the star condition, so here we can see the load ratings for this is 0.94 amperes right now, and at the other two phases we'll check it. This is 0.35 right now, and at the blue one this is showing no current. So for checking the current in blue, we'll turn on the first MCB of the blue phase as well. Here you can see the current loading right now is 1 ampere for this as well. Similarly, we'll turn on the second MCB for the B phase also. So we'll check the current in B phase, which is also 1 ampere for this. So as per the loading steps, you can increase all the MCBs with the different type of loading current. Just measure the current with any of the current measurement equipment and set the desired current rating so that what you can load can be provided with any of the source whose testing, whose calibration you want to do. So we'll increase the all steps of this complete loading. Here you can see, as I am increasing the maximum current load, the humming noise of all the inductors are now increasing, so that load is generated according to the ampere ratings. Now we will check the ampere ratings at the maximum condition of all the phases. So at the R phase we are getting up to 5.33 amperes. At the B phase we are getting 5.42, this is slightly higher, and at the B phase also we are getting 5.38 ampere. So we can say you can use all the star condition load up to 5 amperes for the maximum condition. Each phase is provided with this inductive load in the star condition. Now we will turn off the main MCB, all the loads MCB, and switch it to the off condition. Make sure do not turn the switch while main MCB is on, that can be harm the switch and other components inside the complete load arrangement. We are going to test this load in the delta condition. We have offering the maximum phase to phase per phase current in the delta is up to 15 amperes, which are specification rated. And now we will check with the actual practical condition what can the load is offering from this inductive load at the delta condition. So we will turn on the main switch, turn this to the delta, this selector switch, and we will turn on the main MCB. All the three phases are now present. Right now no current is passing through at any of the phases. And in the blue there is almost zero current. Now we'll turn on the first MCB, where you can see the load is going through the R phase, which is up to 2 ampere, and similar is also going in the Y phase, because in the delta two phases are included in the first combination. So current is flowing through the two phases. In the blue one right now no current or negligible current is flowing. So when we turn on the second MCB, the current will be also flowing with the blue phase also. Here you can see when I turn on the MCB, you can see in the blue phase the current is 2.04 ampere. Similarly, current will be increased in the Y phase, because on the voltage provided at the Y and B phase, the current is increased because it is taking current from R and Y also, and Y and B, both the type of current is provided. So similarly we can increase all the three MCBs and we can check the load in Y is still about 3.68. In the red phase 3.95, and in the blue phase this is 3.79 amperes. So at the first step all the three phases are now taking about 4 amperes or 3.5 amperes. Similarly you can increase all the steps, and at every step it will take about 3 amperes of rating. So we'll quickly increase all the loads and check the maximum load conditions for all the three phases. So we'll increase all the steps one by one for performing the balance load. Here you can see as the ampere loading is increased, the humming noise of the inductor loads are also increasing. So we can check the load here. This is 18.60 in the red phase. Similarly for the Y phase, this is 18.4, and for blue phase this is also 18.68 ampere. The demonstration of this three phase and single phase inductive load is now completed. Here you can see the single phase ratings of this load is about 15 amperes for the safety conditions. Up to safety measures, it can withstand up to 16 amperes or 16.8 amperes that we have observed in this video earlier. But I will suggest you to provide the load up to 15 amperes as suggested in the specification ratings also. On the delta conditions, it is experiencing about 18 amperes approximately current, but at per phase ampere you can withstand this load and provide the power source up to testing of 15 amperes which is suggested at each phase. In the star condition, you can see the load conditions are up to 5 amperes per phase, so that you can easily provide up to 5 amperes of any of the power source for testing it. You can use this at balanced and unbalanced condition. Just turn the switch numbers of the MCB's numbers according to your current requirement at every phase. So we'll discuss about the applications of this. So this type of loads, inductive loads, are can be used for testing of turbine sets, all the diesel engine generator sets. Also this type of loads can be used for the battery and UPS production testing, so that you can easily provide different type of loads to the output of battery and UPS, how they are reacting to the different type of load condition. There are some more applications. The different type of applications are given. Also that can be used in the practical labs for the electrical and electronics students for studying up the about the different type of load conditions in which inductive load can be suitably introduced for different type of load arrangements. You can operate this load as I described in this video, as I suggested in this video. Also you can refer the user manual, all the instructions are given in that. Till then, if you find more difficulties while working with this load, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. So if you like the content of this video and you find this video very useful for your learning, you can like this video on YouTube, and also you can share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about the inductive load conditions, how the inductive loads are used in different type of single phase and three phase power supplies. And also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos with different type of educational trainers with the hands-on practical experience are uploaded, so that you can clear your different type of interesting topic to your education related guidance. So go there and also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos with different type of educational trainers with the practical experience and practical explanations are uploaded, so that you can go through with the different type of videos and clear your interesting topics of your education guidance. Don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video with a new type of technology and new type of educational trainer, so that you get notified about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.